Hi, I'm Jason with AlarmSystemStore.com. Today's video is part two in our series for the Alarm.com communicators on the DSC PowerSeries NEO. Part one went over the programming. Go check that out if you need to do that still. This portion, we're going to go over the wiring for the communicator. So let's go to the panel and we'll get started. The first step for wiring up the Alarm.com communicator is going to be to mount the PC link board on the side of the cabinet. And you'll want to put it right here. You can put it other places, but we're going to be connecting from the PC link 2 here to the PC link here. Our cable's not that long. We can put it in other locations and still reach, but this is kind of the most out of the way, closest location. So we'll start by putting our standoffs through the cabinet in the holes that we'll be using to mount the board. And it's these three holes here. And then we'll line up the holes on the board with those. And they'll only line up in one direction, so you can't mount it in the wrong direction. So there you have it, snapped into place, not going anywhere. So the PC link cable will go from, again, PC link 2. So you have PC link 1, PC link 2. I'll try to get the camera as close as possible so you can see that. So we're going to use PC link 2, and on the board, right there, it in white ink, it says red. So you can see we have the one red wire here. So we're going to want to put that red wire closest to the red printed on the board. So you just push that in place all the way, just like that. And now on the PC link board, try to get a good angle on it here. You have M1 right there. So M1 is actually where the red wire will go on the PC link board. So again, you just line up the red wire with that pin, and there you have it. So that's all there is for that. Next, we will be wiring up our six wires on these terminals here. So the first ones are easy, and those are going to be the power wires. So I'm using 2 4 conductor wires. The wire that I'm going to be using, I've kind of marked on both ends the one I'm using for power just by folding back the two extra. So I'm just using red and black. It's like that on the same end, or on the other end over there. So red will go to positive 12, and black will go to ground. So plus 12 volt right here, ground right next to it. So just like that. And usually these would be going through the cabinet, through the back of the wall. But just so it's easier to see, I'm not doing that in this case. So now we have four more wires that we're going to use on TX plus, TX minus, RX plus, and RX minus. So it doesn't really matter which wire you use for which, but make sure you keep track of how you're doing it. So the way I'm going to be doing it is I'm going to be using red on TX plus, black on TX minus, green on RX plus, and white on RX minus. So we'll wire that up. Now the reason you want to keep this straight is pretty obvious. because you'll want to make sure that each wire is going to the correct terminal on the communicator. Now I'll go over it again at the communicator, but one of our biggest mistakes is that people wire TX to TX and RX to RX. It's actually crossed over, so TX will actually go to RX on the other end. So T stands for transmit, R stands for receive. So we're transmitting from the board to the receive of the communicator and vice versa. And then positive, positive, negative, negative. So TX plus goes to RX plus, TX minus to RX minus, and vice versa. So we got those wired up, PC links in place, keeping the red wire in the proper position. So by red on PC link 2 and the M1 on the PCL422. And that's the only wiring that we need to do in the cabinet. The interface module makes it pretty easy. You don't have to add any additional wires. Sometimes it can get pretty crowded in your key bus and things like that. So it's nice having something like this. Kind of keeps everything out of the way. So now we'll go to the communicator and do the wiring there. All right, so here we are at the communicator itself. So let's start by opening it up. There's a couple tabs on the side here where you pry it open. Okay, so here is the terminals that we're going to be connecting to. TX plus minus, RX plus minus, grounded 12 volt. And to get the wire there, there's a couple slots to run your wires through. And some breakouts on the side here so that it lays flat against the wall. You know, you just run it through following the arrows. Just helps keep the wire locked in place. You can run it straight through the back if you have a hole in the wall, however you need to do it. In this case, I'm just going to run it straight through the back since I'm not too worried about it laying flat for the video here. Okay, so I'm using two wires again. I've already got the power wire marked just by folding these two wires back. And then here's going to be my communication wires here, the TX and RX wires. So let's start with the power wires. These are simple. Black wire goes to ground, and the red wire goes to 12 volt plus. Alright, now we got our red and black, and our green and white or yellow as it usually will be. So, red was going to TX plus on the PCL422. So this is where the most common mistake comes in. You don't wire TX to TX, you wire TX to RX. So TX plus, which is the red wire on the PCL422, will actually go to RX plus. So let's wire that in. And then our black wire was TX plus. Minus, so we're going to wire to RX minus. green wire was RX plus, so it goes to TX plus. And the white wire was RX minus, so it'll go to TX minus. If I can get those lined up. Pull the excess wire out. Check to make sure that nothing's shorted, everything's snug. And then from there, just put the cover back on. That's all there is to that. Next step will be powering up the alarm system. All right, so I've powered up the alarm system. And it'll usually happen pretty quick that it'll initialize. I like to give it about 10 minutes, though, just to make sure. To check that it worked, first you want to make sure that all your LEDs are as expected. So I've got a few flashing here, which mean various things. My signal level, of course, is we're in a metal building, kind of in the middle of it. So not an ideal location to place this communicator. So we have a pretty bad signal. Strength, but probably enough for our purposes for this video. So, easiest way to check to see if it's worked is to enter *8 followed by your installer code, and then go to section 851. So as you can see, it says alarm.com module status. So if it says this, then you know that the panel and the communicator are talking to each other. Now, the communicator may not be talking to alarm.com yet, but at least the two are initialized together properly. If you just get here, enter subsection, when you go to 851, that means that it did not work right. So it could be a wiring issue. Usually that's the case. It could be that you wired it up before you did the programming and it just didn't initialize properly. So from here, once you've done that, it's best to go to communications test, and it'll actually force the communicator to try to talk to alarm.com. So you see test signal okay, and then check central station report. So that's good. That means that communicator's talking to alarm.com. And once you've reached this point, you should be able to then, if you've gotten with us to get your alarm.com account set up, at that point you should be able to log in using the welcome email that you would have received. So one last thing I'm going to show you is how to get the serial number. So generally, people will send us a serial number as soon as they open the box. You can get it off the back of the communicator. It's on a sticker right there. It says SN, and then it'll have the 10-digit number there. If you've already got it mounted on the wall, though, you got to this point, didn't send it to us, communicator is mounted, you could pop it open, and it's printed on the communicator as well, on the actual circuit board. But a really easy way is to actually go into programming to 851, and then you're going to go to alarm.com module status, and then just scroll over a couple times and you'll get to SN, and here's the serial number for you. So if you get to this point, still didn't send us a serial number, it's pretty easy to get right off the keypad. The wiring for the communicator is a little bit more difficult than the programming was, but it's still not that hard. Just make sure you keep straight all your wires, that you're doing the crossing from TX to RX, and make sure you know where the red wire on your PC link cables are going. As long as you keep that straight, you should be good to go. If you like the video, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.